Oh, there's a river that winds on forever. I'm gonna see where it leads. Oh, there's a mountain that no man has mounted. I'm gonna stand on the peak. Out there's a land that time don't command. Wanna be the first to ride.
Hey, it's September 4th, 2016, and I'm in Sequoia National Forest. We're supposed to hit the trailhead tomorrow, which is the High Sierra Trail. But we got here around 1 o'clock, and we got on the trail, but we started on the Alta Trail, which connects to the High Sierra Trail. So we just started the Alta Trail. Give you a quick look around. A lot of greenery here. And so here's a sign right here. Wolverine Cutoff and then High Sierra Trail, 3.9 miles. So we got probably about a couple hours. So what I'll do is I'll turn it back on. Once we get to the cutoff to the High Sierra Trail, I'll film that part, just so you know where the intersection is. All right, I just came off the Alta Trail. So this is where the Alta Trail and the High Sierra Trail meet. So I would guess 5 miles is where the junction is. And then this is the High Sierra Trail going east now. The Alta Trail was very little elevation, a lot of downhill. We just came down a bunch of switchbacks. A couple people that we passed said, hey, there's a bear on the switchbacks, but we didn't see him, so. Well, since we had to start off lately yesterday, we had the night hike the last 3 miles to Nine Mile Creek. Just give you a quick view. Here's some deer over here. And here is Nine Mile Creek. And the bear box is over here. A couple campsites. And the creek is just up there where you have lots of water. Well, we just left Nine Mile Creek, 8:06 this morning. We're getting close to Bear Paw. And I just wanted to give you a view here. So, this is a where I just came from, and view here. Well, I just came up the switchbacks to get to Bear Paw. When I was hiking up there, it seemed kind of brutal. But once you get up there, you're like, oh. Wasn't that bad. So we're just entering Bear Paw with the ranger station and the camp tent. So here is the sign. Hamilton Lake, that's where we're going tonight. 4 miles. And then, yeah, Crescent Meadows, 11.3, that's somewhat where we started. So here's the, let's see, the tents over here. Big tents up in the trees over there. We got some nice chairs over here. The Great Western Divide. Here's this patio that I've always seen in other videos. like someone slipped there on the ground. So there it is. And I believe we are heading over there and then up to that gap right up there. Okay, just leaving Bear Paw, had about a half hour break, and they do sell Pepsi there for $3. So take a look at the trail. Going back there. There's Bear Paw. And about 1.6 miles down. And then gonna have lunch there. And then I think it's like 2 miles, 2.5 miles up to Hamilton Lake. So that's gonna take a while. I'm still heading down from Bear Paw. Just about halfway to the bottom there. I just come around the corner here, I'll show you all the granite. Alright, just coming down to the last switchback to the very bottom here, and I turn the corner and there's that bridge where the original one was wiped out by an avalanche. There's the view over here. And here you can see the old one line right there. There it goes that way. And then it looks like we go up there. Somewhere up there. There's the trail that goes up there. Granite rocks here. There's the trail where it came from. So I'm hoping to get to Hamilton Lake soon. There we'll set up camp and stay there. Hopefully get there around 1400. Well, I made it to Hamilton Lake, set up camp, went swimming, did laundry, and now I'm about to eat dinner. So it's just gonna give you a view of the camp here. All right, so here's my tent. There's the mountain up there. Here, I'll show you what the lake looks like. There's the lake. And tomorrow, we're heading up there, up there, up those switchbacks, along the ridge, and then over the top there. So I think right up there in that corner. It is September 6th. I left Hamilton Lake this morning. It was 8:40. And I'm going up to Kiwi Gap. And I think it's an over 2,000 foot gain in elevation. Hamilton Lake is around 8,000. And the gap is up a little over 10,000 feet. Just give you a view right now. The lake is down there, but I just went around this one switchback here, over here, and I'm coming around this bend, and And so this is kind of a break the whole way up. Since we started this morning, it's been an uphill climb. So there it is. There's the lake down there. Another view here. Down there is where I slept for the night. And way out the distance around the corner there is where we started. One more pan around. Just after a little bit noon, and we left Precipine Lake and currently heading over the gap. So we're gonna try to make it to Moraine Lake, and I think we have a 14-mile day today. That included the climb up here over the gap, and just want to give you a view here. This is a going through the gap, kind of like a canyon here. I didn't even know there was a little pond up here. Still walking through the gap here. The rock formations are just unbelievable. It's really awesome. Well, through there, here we go. Well, it's about 20 minutes later. I'm still walking through the gap, but it's like I'm coming up on something that was crazy. So, that's awesome. All right. So, I'm not sure what lake that is. Started up there somewhere, right up there. So we came down a bunch of switchbacks. So we're gonna film after going through the gap. This is what you can experience. Well, today is September 7th, about 7:52. We're at Arroyo Creek, and we just packed up our campsite. Here's the campsite real quick. That's where we slept. Had a campfire, and last night got woken up by mules because they had cowbells on them, and so it came right up to our camp, and we got out and shooshed them away. But I had earplugs in, so I was lucky they didn't keep me up all night. So I was talking to some other people, and they said they didn't have earplugs and they were up all night. So There's another campsite right there. Sun's coming up. It's cold. It was cold last night. Probably close to freezing, I'm not sure. But the frost wasn't frozen on my tent, but sure it was cold. In fact, I'm cold right now. As soon as I get in the sun, it should be a lot warmer. Yeah, there's the sign. Big Arrow Trail. Give you a look around here. About an hour later, just summited the mountain here. And then after this, it looks like the rest of the way will be downhill for the rest of the day. So, just want to show you what I'm coming up to. Kind of a look, looks like a lookout. There's really neat trees here. You can see over there. And come around the corner. I have no idea who these crazy people are.
Hey,
coming through.
Hi.
But they look friendly, but you can't judge from looks. We just got to the junction where you can go to Marine Lake, and we're gonna skip that. It saves us, I think, 0.8 miles. So this is a meadow that we just came up to. Give you a quick view here. Little meadow, stream, fire pit. And that's where we're heading up there. Still heading down the switchbacks on Kern River. It's getting steeper and steeper, so I just wanted to give you a view. This is where I came from. And there's the valley down there with the river. There, but instead of going south, we're going to be going north. Probably going to be in that valley for a long time. Hiking up here. So we made it down to the bottom of Kern River. You can see right there, and we've been hiking for. Maybe a half mile on this one trail here, and we're gonna cross over the river and get on the High Sierra Trail and try to get to the Kern Springs. So that would bring us close to 15 miles, so it's like 14.9 or something like that. So I'll just show you how to cross the bridge here. I'm just walking into Kern's Hot Springs. It was a little confusing. I thought we were lost. The GPS didn't have us exactly on the trail. And I don't know, it wasn't great. It wasn't marked really well. So this is it. It's next to the river here. Hot spring. Yeah, I think this is a hot spring. Right there. not that grand. Wow. It's supposed to be 115 degrees coming out of the ground. So just jump in there and you clean off. Try to find a campsite, and then well, we're at Kern's Hot Springs, just set up camp. It's about 1600. Got my tent all set up, so that's where I'll be sleeping tonight. And here's some of the view. You can focus up there, over there, and then the latrines over there. And then the rest of the camp, there's the bear locker. There's Ryan doing laundry. Campfire, Ryan's tent, and Kevin's tent. Alright, we have a stream over there. That's where we're getting our water at. Just had dinner, feel a little bit better. I did laundry. As you can see, it's hanging right there. And then I would love take a bath. Well, I'm sitting in the hot spring. They say it's 115 degrees. So I'll just give you a quick look right here. And nice view. And we hiked close to 15 miles a day. I am definitely tired. A lot of it was downhill, so we'll see how tomorrow. I think we're doing, 8 or 9 miles. Well, I'm laying in my tent in Kern's Hot Springs area, and I just wanted to show you from the inside what it looks like and what I sleep in every night. I'll just give you a pan view here. My tent's held by trekking poles. And so that way it saves me on weight. And then I have a down-filled sleeping quilt. My sleeping bag goes here. Laundry there. Pillow and sleeping pad. And then I have another sleeping pad on my knee that I use to sit on at camp and stuff like that. And then that sits underneath just to increase the comfort. So, well, I had a really good layover at the Kern's Hot Springs. It's about 8:15 Thursday morning, September 8th. Just cleaned up, and here's some of the views here. Surrounded by canyons. And that's Kern's Hot Springs. And next is Junction Meadows. And it's roughly 8 miles to go. So hopefully we'll get there around 1 or 2. Made it to Junction Meadow. Close to 8 miles. From Kern Springs, what we decided to do is hike another 4 miles to Wallace Creek, and that's where we hit the JMT. However, there's going to be a 2,000 foot elevation gain, and it's 137, so it's going to be hot, and it's going to be a long, strenuous trip. So just up here is the sign. And we'll see what it says. Really nice trees over here. Colby Pass is 8.5. John Muir Trail, 4.3. And Whitney, 16 miles. So, that's where we're heading. Well, we're heading up the switchbacks. We're about almost a mile in. We have 3 more miles to go. A little bit windy, which is good. Kind of keeps us cool. Right down there, there's a little stream. There's the peak there. Get another view. There's the valley, which we walked up. This is Wallace Creek. We probably have just a couple more hundred, maybe 100 or 200 feet to go in elevation. Today is Friday, September 9th. Connected with the JMT around 16:30 yesterday, and there was a campsite right there. Had dinner, and then woke up at 6:30 this morning. It's probably the best sleep I've had on the trail. Earplugs help, and putting your head inside the sleeping bag helps when the sun comes up. It was cold, but it wasn't below freezing, so it was pretty warm. Right now, I'm on the JMT and halfway to Crabtree. There's a ranger station there. Just went up some elevation, coming back down. I believe I saw Mount Whitney in the background. Not 100% sure. Maybe when I come up here, I'll show you. Here's a really good view of the meadow, and I believe that is Mount Whitney back there. So that's where we're headed. I think we're about 9 miles right now. It's September 10th, and woke up this morning about 4:30, broke camp, and we all headed out at 6 in the morning here. We had a change of plans. We're not going to go and stay at Guitar Lake. What we're going to do is hike up to Guitar Lake and then summit Mount Whitney and then go down past Trail Camp and then stay at Trail Outpost. So it's going to be a long day. Thinking 14 miles today. I'm not 100% sure, but I think that's accurate, somewhat accurate. Right now, so I'm between Crabtree Meadow and Guitar Lake. I'm at Timberland Lake or something like that. And just want to give you a quick view. So right there is Mount Whitney. And then you have a little lake over here. The sunrise, you can see way in the distance the peaks. Here's the trail. So this is from Crabtree to Guitar. It's 2.7 miles. And I'm about halfway to Guitar Lake. So far the elevation hasn't been too bad. Looks like there's some up ahead. I think Guitar Lake's around 12,000. And then Whitney is 14.5. So I think we're doing around 4,000 elevation today. We weren't keen to get up at 1 or 2 in the morning and summit it to see the sunrise. But it would have been nice to see, because it is a gorgeous day. It's been nice every day. Blue skies, no clouds, and moderate temperatures. I am coming up on Guitar Lake. It's kind of like a barren landscape here. And there's the top of the guitar. There's the lake. And then up Mount Whitney, up that way. It's almost 9 o'clock, it's like 8:55, and I just checked my iPhone and the altimeter says that I am at 12,500 feet right now. So it's like I have 12,000 feet. So far as like 12,000 feet right there. trying to walk with the wind so it doesn't affect it too much. Starting to feel the altitude. I have to take more breaks, catching wind. I'll catch my breath. So I just want to give you a look. Right now, you know, there's the trail. There's Guitar Lake off in the distance. There's the Great Western Divide, which we crossed a couple days ago. What the trail looks like. Some parts are really rocky. Some parts have like steps. They really burn your thighs. It is 11:43. I just made it to the Smithsonian Susan Hodgson Fund building here. Please don't wake me now. The hut. It's about 20 minutes later from leaving the peak. Just wanted to show you the windows up there, and then you got those big ones right there. So I'll just show you how the trail is going down a little bit here. We're going all the way over there. Got the Guitar Lake. Just came up to another window. Just wanted to show you. There's Lone Pine, and it is a long way down there. And actually, all those pine trees, that's where we slept last night. And this is the first day that we've actually seen all of the clouds. Every day since last Sunday, It's been clear blue skies. Looks like it might be raining way out there. Just made it down to the junction. This is where we came down. This is the sign. Whitney Portal 8.7, Crabtree Ranger Station 5.5. That's where we came from this morning. And Mount Whitney 1.9. So this is where the backpackers leave all their stuff. And I got a little uphill here, and then a 99 switchbacks going down. Just coming up to the trail crust. So, trail crust is 13,600 feet. There's just one section coming down the switchbacks, and there's a railing and lots of ice. Looks like it's coming down from here. Today is September 11th. This is Outpost camp. So this is where we stayed last night. Now, from the junction on Whitney to Whitney Portal is 8.5 miles. After we summited Whitney, we went back down to the junction, and then we hiked, I believe it was 5 miles down to this outpost. There is a base camp at the bottom of the 99 switchbacks. But up there, I think it's around 12,000, and here was 10,000 feet. And then we only have 3.5 miles to hike to Whitney Portal, and that will be the end of the trip. It's a really nice camp, as you can see. Big canyons up here. And nice little waterfall up there. Well, this ends the High Sierra Trail, back to civilization, work, family. So, this is it. We'll be right back.
country dearly. I can feel the ladder clearly, but I never thought I'd be alone to try. Once I was outside Penn Station, selling red and white carnations. We were still alone, my wife and I. Before we married, saved my money, brought my dear wife over. Now I work to bring my family stateside. But off the boat they stayed a while and scattered across the coast. Once a year I'll see them for a week or so at most. I should go up. Tonight.